Hi, I'm Daria Fissoun, and in this video, we'll be taking a look at the waveform scope. A lot of the information presented here will be applicable to any software that utilizes scopes, but I'll also be showcasing some of the features that are unique to Nobe OmniScope. Let's get started. The waveform displays the luminance, or the levels, of the red, green, and blue channels in your footage. This waveform is set to luminosity mode. Vertically, it represents the luminance values of the image. The bottom of the scope represents the darkest potential point on a display, and the top represents the whitest. Horizontally, you are seeing your image as it appears in the frame, with its pixels redistributed based on their luminance values. The image readout we see in the scope is called a trace. You can figure out what part of a frame is being represented in the waveform by noting its position on the horizontal axis and looking in the same region in the source viewer. When using OmniScope, hold the Option or Alt modifier key to preview the frame you're on and to see its distribution in the waveform. Waveforms allow us to do many things, both technical and creative. Looking at the waveform allows us to see and adjust the tonal distribution of an image and determine with certainty if any part of it is under or overexposed. You can ensure consistency in your scenes by matching the waveform levels across different clips. Waveforms are also commonly used to ensure your project is meeting legal levels prior to professional delivery. Right-click in the waveform scope to reveal additional controls in the contextual menu. Enable Colorize to include color in the trace, which can be helpful for locating skin tones or monitoring objects with distinct colors. You can also choose to select a zoom area to monitor a predefined range of the highlights or shadows. It's common practice to place a zoomed-in waveform alongside the full version for more detailed analysis of your project as you work. The Mode submenu allows you to change how the video signal is presented in the waveform. RGB will display your individual channel intensities overlaid over one another. Enable Colorize to see them more distinctly, and adjust the RGB channels in your grading software to balance neutral elements in the footage. Parade modes will place your channels alongside each other so you can more clearly distinguish their relationship. This can be very helpful because the luminosity waveform on its own cannot always reveal overexposure if there's a high signal intensity in only one color. This is why it's best to have multiple scopes open as you grade. Parade scopes are often used for both balancing and shot matching work. If there's a neutral object in the scene, like a white piece of paper or a black t-shirt, its trace in the parades should be at equal levels in order for the image to be balanced. Of course, this might not apply to scenes with deliberately dramatic lighting. When it comes to matching, you need to first assess the spatial difference between the three channels of the clip you want to match. Use your grading software to then replicate that spatial relationship in the clip that you're matching to produce consistent colors throughout your scene. Just like in the luminosity scope, you can hold the Option or Alt modifier key to review the image distribution within the trace. There are a few more ways you can interact with the source signal viewer to help with your waveform analysis. Drag in the viewer to isolate that section of the trace. This can quickly help you find the luminance levels of a specific element in the scene. Hold Shift and drag to keep that selection in place until your next click. Hold Option or Alt to see the exact location of a pixel in the waveform. Click to retain it in the viewer and leave a marker in the waveform scope. Double-click its RGB values in the viewer to remove it. Back in the contextual menu, the most advanced controls for the tools in OmniScope can be found in the settings. At the top, you can rename any scope title. This can be helpful if you're setting up multiple variants of a tool. Use the four tabs underneath to switch between the different grouped settings. Some of the parameters will match the ones you see in the contextual menu, but some will be brand new. Enhanced Render allows you to switch from point-only rendering to a mixture of both point and line rendering to produce a more accurate, easier-to-read waveform. Smooth Trace applies a low-pass filter and gamma adjustment, resulting in a more detailed trace with better visibility. By default, all the scopes adopt the scale values specified in the input settings of the Connect menu. Use the Scale Override to change individual scope values. When working with HDR standards like PQ and HLG, you will unlock the ability to set a custom mastering level. At the bottom, you can choose to apply a custom low-pass filter to the signal before the waveform is generated. This reduces superfluous video data and can result in a more readable trace. In the Appearance tab, you can artificially enhance the edges of the trace for better visibility of the highlights and shadows. When working with colorized parades, the waveforms appear tinted by default. Enable true red, green, and blue for a purer RGB parade. Show peak levels will place red line indicators and a numeric readout on the highest and lowest points of the trace. This can be helpful on footage with subtle highlights or shadows, and for more accurate matching across shots. You can further customize the appearance of the waveform trace and radicules using channel spacing, top and bottom margin, and left margin controls. Use gain to adjust the brightness of the trace. When making adjustments in the sliders, hold Ctrl or Command and click to manually enter values. To reset all parameters to their default values, right-click the scope and choose Reset Settings. Use the Source tab to override the project-wide color space and 3D LUT defined in the Input Settings window. And while we're looking at the global input settings, if an incoming signal is in the video or legal range, you have the option to monitor it as is, or use this checkbox to extend it to the full range of the waveform scope. This is often done to make waveforms more readable and not waste precious real estate in the scope window. If you are using OmniScope Pro, you will have the option to assign custom targets. These can be extremely helpful if you're trying to meet specific legal values or want consistent highlights and shadows on a stylized project. Outside of the waveform scope, there are also some global target controls you might want to use. In the View menu, open the Targets tool. Here, you can enable and disable targets across all the scopes. For waveforms, you'll want to use the Luma targets. Drag the slider to set a target marker and press New Luma Target to introduce as many guides as you need. You can then use Ctrl or Command T to toggle these guides while working. I hope this video has given you a better understanding of how to use the OmniScope waveform. For more information, check out the video description for the official documentation. We'll see you in the next video. Remember to like this video and subscribe to be notified of all future training videos and OmniScope announcements.